Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? This is a reaction video. On this video here, Immersion Pods 3, extraterrestrial technology, and the information is coming from a Pleiadian ET named Anika from the planet Timur. Tegeta is a star in the Pleiadian constellation, and Timur is one of the planets going around that. And this is where Anika is from. Now, these ET contacts, these Pleiadians, they're human. And they have made contact with Gosha and others here on Earth. And their communication is through text, live, interactive, direct contact. Go to Cosmic Agency. It's a YouTube channel. To find many more videos on this subject of immersion pods and many other subjects. And I've been studying this whole ET stuff for like over 40 years. I've done a lot of work, spiritual work on myself and on others. So I have had a lot of previous information about ETs and this phenomenon, the multidimensionality of reality and all these things. When I started listening to the Tegetan Pleiadian ETs from the Cosmic Agency, I have never heard any ET information that resonated so well with what I already understood or what I felt fit perfectly within my understanding or belief systems about how reality is. And some of the best teachers or presenters of information over the last 40 years, I had in here when I listened to Anika or Yasky or Swaru or Athena Swaru. I listened to these ET girls from the Pleiadians, from the Pleiades. And the questions and answers that came through as Gosha asks them questions, you know, it's just fires up my mind. It's like, whoa, this stuff is so good. It's like, I know, you know, I've watched stuff that was full of strangeness and weirdness and stuff. And this is the most legit, authentic, real information that I've ever come across in 40 years. More like 50, okay. I started when I was 20. I started this path. All right. So with that said, this is the third video on what are called immersion pods. And an immersion pod is basically like in the movie Avatar, where the guy goes into a pod and he does a consciousness transference and puts his consciousness into the avatar, the giant blue avatar body. So it's like that, right? So you've probably seen this and heard this in other science fiction stories. But this is what we're talking about. They're real. This is a real deal. And if you haven't watched or you're not up to speed on the Tegetan team and the contact information from the Pleiades, from this particular source, you got to check them out. You can check them out at Cosmic Agency on YouTube. All right. And before we get started, I want to say thank you so much to Gosha. You're doing such a fantastic job being the intermediary, being the contactee, being boots on the ground for the rest of us, and your ability to ask the right questions and get the most out of an interaction is just awesome. And I want to say a really big thank you to Anika. Did I mention I had the opportunity to talk to Anika myself? Anika, myself, in a text chat, direct back and forth interaction with Anika, and I had an opportunity to talk to Yasky direct. She's a sweetheart. She's the most intelligent, well-informed, educated, passionate, and caring being I've met. Okay. She cares, and she's doing what she can to help us awaken and understand what's going on. And I also had the good fortune to directly communicate with Athena Swaru. So it's Yaski Swaru, also known as Swaru 12, because there's so many of the Swaru incarnations that they kind of got numbers, right? So Swaru 12, that's Yaski. Swaru 10, or also known as Swaru X, that's Athena Swaru. And Swaru 9 just was mainly going by the name of Swaru, because she was like the first one that showed up, and she was just using her her Swaru name, not knowing, not really thinking about there other might be other of the Swaru girls showing up. So anyway, let's just see a little quick background before we get started in this. And Annika is like the intelligence officer, chief operations officer for intelligence and a few other things. So she's really high up in this whole thing as well. And as you listen to these various videos, if you haven't heard about these people, you got to go there and check it out. They talk about, they're so well informed. They understand what's going on Earth so well, with the New World Order, the super rich power elite, what's going on from a health perspective, the health and you got to dance around the words, right? But they can really give you a lot of information of what's going on there as well. It's just fucking amazing how much they know and how well they present it and how well it fits the reality that I know and understand and have agreed with and have experienced in this life. Good stuff. All right, that's enough of that. Let's get started here. This is my reaction on this video, third installment, Immersion Pods 3.
Can you do a 3D immersion by managing two or more avatars, like with the example of twins?
Yes, you can. The person needs some prior training, but technically, more than one body can be handled at the same time. Yes, it happens like with twins.
How and when an experience in the immersion is designed? For example, being in a mountain, alpinism.
If it is a playful immersion, just for entertainment, it can be designed just before, or the immersion can be designed while it is in progress. In this case, you're fully aware that you are immersed.
Okay, here's the thing. I want to set this up because this is very important to me. As I have been listening to these immersion pod videos, I start asking, hey, am I in one of these immersion pods? And if so, how would I know? And why can't I remember it? And as I gather more information, I realize that some of it has to do with the programming. It's like we program the experience before we step into the immersion pod, and then we go do it. Now, if we've made agreements, it's part of the program to not remember, then we're not going to remember, right? And now if we get down here on the earth plane, on earth, with an immersion pod, where is it? On another planet? Is it on a spacecraft? Where is it? I don't know. But if I'm down here and I've changed my mind, I go, you know, it was a great idea. And I don't think mine was a playful immersion. I didn't come here to play. A lot of ETs do that. They're like, they are not human. But they have been able to step into an immersion pod with their little program of, here, this is what I'm going to do. And they might spend a whole life here, or they might spend a few weeks. But for them, it's play. They know what they're doing. And of these that do that, they might have programmed in there that they know fully well that they're not human and they're playing human. Yeah. I've had clients that say they have come face to face with people like this. They can look right at them and say, this person is not human. They can play act, being human. They can be real kind and nice. And they might look real handsome or beautiful. And they'll be all friendly. And then they'll change on you. And it's like the way they think and the feel and the energy of these entities or these beings. Is this person even human? No, they're not. But they're in human bodies. It's a real mind fuck is what it is. Now, once again, I highly encourage you to watch the other two Immersion Pod videos because this is the most fascinating subject. When I explain why you're here and you can't remember what the hell, you know, you feel like this is your first time here, you know, kind of like that. I just want to react as we go along because this is just mind-blowing stuff.